أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, there was once a Jewish man during the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه who came to him during his khilafah and he said, in your book there is a verse that if we had it in our Torah, if we had it in our religion, we would have made that day a day of celebration. We would have made that day a sacred day. And he asked him, what verse is that? So he responded, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. And so Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, by Allah, I know when it was revealed and where it was revealed. It was revealed on a Friday on the day of Arafat, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was doing his final Hajj. And indeed, it is a day of celebration. It is a day of joy. It is a day where the name of Allah Jalla Jalalu is raised high, where our problems are put on the back burner. And what we focus on is the ni'mah that we have before us, the ni'mah of Islam. And that causes us joy and celebration, not just because of the ni'mah, but also because it's the defeat of our enemy and his demise, Iblis, la'anahu Allah, in which the days of the Hijjah are the days in which Adam was forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a day of desecration for Iblis. It's also the day in which Ibrahim alayhi salam, our father, was able to overcome his deception and follow through with the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's also a day in which this verse was revealed, putting despair in the heart of Iblis when it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And every year since, when the Hujjaj throw their stones, and they slaughter for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, solely for his sake, Iblis falls in despair and desecration. And so it's a moment of joy. It's a moment of celebration for us at the demise of our enemy and a forgiveness for us in our sins and our mistakes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds. Brothers and sisters, just an important reminder, and this khutbah will be short. Make sure that this day is a day of joy and celebration. Yes, it's beautiful to get caught in the moment of the ibadah, such as slaughtering for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, going to the farms, or coming to salah, or doing these manasik and ibadat. That has a beauty to it. But there's also a joyous element that we cannot forget. If we have fought with family members, or loved ones, or friends, now is the time to make up. Because now, the person's ego is on the side, and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending. Take advantage of that moment and seek each other's forgiveness. Reach out to people that perhaps you didn't reach out to before. And remember your brothers and sisters who are probably estranged from their families or converts or have lost loved ones in these hard times and difficult times or have gone through difficult moments with their relationships and perhaps they need that moment of consolation and that moment of connection. And so take advantage of that and reach out to the people that you know. Reach out to your loved ones and reach out to those who are new Muslims. Remind them that we are all today one family. We are all brethren in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Indeed, the believers are but brothers, so make peace with one another. Now is the time to reconcile. Now is the time to overcome those differences. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to do that and overcome the whispers of Iblis. Brothers and sisters, it's not just with the stranger, but as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, الْأَقْرَبُونَ أَوْلَى بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Those who are closest to you are more rightful to your goodness. And so your children, your family, your spouses, your loved ones, make sure that they see your best behavior today. Make sure that your children, when they look back and you're buried in the grave, they'll look back and say, may Allah have mercy on my parents. When Eid came along, I was happy. Have it a moment of, you know, going out to eat dinner or going out to some kind of celebration that you may have. Because we live in a time where society is pressuring our children from the faith. And now is the time where we invest in the good memories. because that's what's going to hold them tight. That's what's going to hold them firm to this religion. And so invest in those moments. You won't regret it when you're in the grave, and you won't regret it when they face a wave of indoctrination around them, and they firmly say, "Amantu billah, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah." May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plant our feet firm. Brothers and sisters, one last piece of advice. Make this day a moment of self-reflection. A moment where you intend, from whatever good you did in Arafat, whatever good you did these past 9 days, or since Ramadan, that next year you're going to do better. That next year you're going to take the stakes higher. If you were able to fast Arafat, fast a few days extra. If you were able to fast the 10 days or the 9 days, then make sure you go out and slaughter. If you were able to go out and slaughter, then do more than you can. Every year raising those stakes, becoming a better version of yourself. It doesn't have to be something drastic, one and done, where you become a perfect version. No, it's something that you're building into. وَهَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. And remember that is the reward for goodness anything but goodness and perfection? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to perform hajj many times in our lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to do many more good deeds in our lives increasingly until the end of our days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our last days the best of our days and forgive our sins and our mistakes. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.